some background information here. Assume that the triglyceride levels of the population are normally distributed. They have to tell you that, or you can't approximate a normal curve. With a standard deviation of 35 milligrams per deciliter, you randomly select a person from your whole population of your United States. What is the probability that that person has a triglyceride level less than 80? So let's pull out the information we need. Do we need this information?
Yeah.
What is that? The mean. What else do we need? Standard deviation. This is your population. We're dealing with the population of people in the United States. Okay? Where's my probability statement? Less than 80. So the probability that X is less than 80. So we're going to build a normal curve. I want to see these sketches. We're going to put the mean in the middle. We're going to add 35 and subtract 35. I'll put them out here because I have them this time. Okay, so where does 80 fall? Between which two standard deviations? Negative 2 and negative 1, somewhere here. We want the shading to the left or to the right? To the left. Is my probability going to be greater than 50% or less than 50%?
Less.
Less. So these are things I want you to get from your sketches. That's a tremendous help. When you do your z-score, if you subtracted it the wrong way and you got a positive, you look at your sketch and say, it's got to be negative. What did I do wrong? I subtracted it the wrong way. If you pull up your... So you use your calculator, when you put the wrong level of limit in there, it's going to tell you, and we'll do this on your calculator as well. So let's use your z-score formula. I want you to start memorizing that. X is your 80, your mean is 134, and your standard deviation, 35. So you come up with a z-score of negative 1.54, and isn't that what you expected? Didn't you expect it to be, your graph said, between negative 1 and negative 2? So I know I'm on track. I look it up in my table first. Let's do your table. I look it up in my table, and I hit this. And I say, yeah, I expect it to be small. It's almost near the negative 2. I expect it to be small. So about 6.2% probability that the person that I pick has a triglyceride level less than 80. That's what, how we interpret this. If we just look at it as 0.0618, that means like nothing to us. 0.0618 means nothing. It means it's a pretty small number. That's all. It's the area under the curve that covered this situation. Do we get this? Are you getting this? Okay, calculator. Remember I told you about the calculator? The calculator is great for these. This is a normal curve. So again, it's a distribution. Don't pick the first one. That's just the probability distribution. The next one is your cumulative one, because we accumulate area from the left to the right, from 0 to 100. We put our pieces in. If we're going to find, use the z-score. If you're more comfortable finding the z-score and then looking this up for your table, then put your lower limit in, lower limit way out there, negative 999. Upper limit, use your z-score. If you use your z-score, you have to use the 0 and the 1. And this will give you your area. And there's my area. Just round it, 0.618. Your calculator is a little bit more exact than we do it because we have rounding issues. You can bypass all of this. I can bypass this. All I have to do is a sketch and this, and go to my calculator, and go normal CDF. You might want to try this, because this is really helpful. I'm still at the negative 999, My upper limit now is 80, my x value. I only want to go to 80. Now I have to put in my mean, and now I have to put in my standard deviation. Your calculator will calculate the rest. It will still give you your final answer. Your calculator is somewhat a little bit different, but overall, close enough. Because your calculator doesn't have to do any rounding. It rounds everything at the end. So if you did this on your calculator, you would tell me calculator, normal CDF, and you'll give me your answer, and I'll know that this came from your calculator.
-999 for the lower upper 80. I
love the mean and sending you along, but then. No. Okay, but you have to put in the one. You have to put it in, not the zero and the one. If you're gonna put the x value in, so here's the rule. If you're gonna put the x value in, then you have to have the mean and the standard deviation of the problem. If you're just gonna put the z score in, then you're gonna go to the zero and the one. So we can do it two different ways. So once you use the x value, put the mean and the standard deviation in. Isn't that simple? It's so simple to use this calculator.
Okay, now I got it. Thank
you. Because we could also do it just with this. Some kids are more comfortable finding the formula first and then plugging in the z-score. That works too. Generally, I can say over the years, it always works out to be about 50% of the kids use a calculator and 50% use the formula. I will always use the formula first so that you see where it's coming from, and then I will usually use the calculator with it to show you how much easier it is. Questions on this at all? Everybody comfortable with this? All right, so we're gonna do some homework problems. Some problems on your own.
Any textbook questions?
Textbook, yep. Okay, let me pull this up and see what ones I wanna give you. Okay, so go to page 249. Do numbers 1 and 3. Do number 7. Number 12. I'm going to give you too many. Number 13. Number 17, and that would be fine. So if you could tell me these again, page 249. What numbers did I give you? 1 and 3, 7, 13, 17. Thank you. Not a lot, guys. Write them down. Write these down. I'm going to shut the light off in a minute. This thing. This light.